Hi, everybody. So
Hi.
Z and Abby are here with me today, and we're going to talk to you about our trip. We had a lot of fun, and we have a new project, and I just want to say welcome to them. So I'm so excited for everything that's happening right now, and I'm glad we're on this journey together.
Yes, so excited.
Great to be here, honey. It
Yeah.
really is. Yeah.
Yeah, we had so much fun. And we were in the Redwoods and it was like really magical. So I kind of want to show those pictures first. But it felt like Land of the Fairies. And this is just from my cell phone. But you can see like that felt like a little portal right there, that little hole. And that's a big tree that had fallen. But it's just amazing in there. If you guys can go, I would definitely go to the Redwoods.
Highly
Yeah, it looks
recommend
like
it.
you
Please go.
captured all the
blue. All that blue. It's almost like the periwinkle was coming through, like it looks a little bit purple. Maybe it's just wishful thinking.
Looks periwinkle. We can say that.
Yeah, we can say that. So,
That last tree there, though, we never saw the top of the tree. And I remember even looking when we went back on the road, I was looking over to see, because sometimes when you're far away from something, I still couldn't see it. It was just
No,
incredible.
I was like underneath it and trying to see it going further up, and I couldn't either. So that was interesting.
You really couldn't. And I'm just a little thing, so I just stood by it and I was like, oh my gosh. It was so big. This is so beautiful out there. The energy is magnificent.
It really is. It was just amazing. And I'm addicted to green. So I was like so happy there. And Abby knows this because I always want to go and like wallow in the grass, like feeling of Ireland.
Funny.
I'm like,
You
is
know
this
what was
real
really
Ireland?
amazing?
Yeah.
But I don't think I told you this. But since we've been there, the magic of the Redwoods is still unfolding in me. And I was in a group session in real life on Tuesday, only a couple of days ago. And we were doing a grounding, and suddenly the Redwood energy just came in for me. And I felt so big and so strong. And it was like that tree that we connected into can c come with us wherever we go from here on in. And just be there to remind us how big we are and how much stillness is possible when you disconnect from stuff. So it was such a beautiful thing to find. You know, that energy is still there with me, even though I'm not physically there anymore.
Yeah, that was one magical tree.
It was
It was
felt
great.
really important for us to be there too, to really ground all that information into our vessels. To really bring that into who we are as beings, who we are in consciousness, and the information that it really does carry. Because right now, again, our vessels are really taking control of evolution here in humanity. And the trees are such a beautiful example of grounding into the self and opening up the space for higher consciousness.
Yeah. What was
Perfect.
fun too is John led us to that tree. So
Yes.
he was so excited about it. And he's like, come back here. And we're like, okay, so it was really great to see him like get more expanded while we were there too. So
Well, he totally knew
like
where he was going.
the tree
Yeah.
spoke through him. I mean,
Yeah.
he had this glow around him, and he's like, there's a tree that you really need to see. And it was almost like the tree wants you to come and see it, and I'm just inviting you. And we would never have found it if he hadn't brought us to it.
Yeah.
So,
Right.
yeah.
Yeah. He was really amazing. That like masculine feature of kind of directing was really cool with him. Like he was driving us around. I only drove a little bit. He was doing a lot of like caretaking with us on that trip. And whenever he would get overwhelmed, he would run away to the basement to watch
But
the
we were doing a lot of work together.
Oh,
And as
yeah.
we were talking about the redwoods there, I just had an image of you, Z, with your little chicken hat running around singing in the forest. And it was like all these trees were your friends, and you just wanted to hug them all. And it was just a joy to watch you, but it was really an honor to meet you in person. I think for people who are watching this to realize that, you think you know someone when you meet them online or through a video, but when you actually meet them in real life, it's another layer, it's another dimension, it's another depth. And I think it's really important that we have these meetings in real life as well, not just to cement our friendships, but to consolidate who we think we are. Like I met Z in real life and I'm like, I know you. And it wasn't because I knew you from the videos. It was like, no, your energy feels like my energy, feels like we're connected. And it was just beautiful. So, yeah.
Absolutely. It was so, I'm so in gratitude for having the ability to do that. And that was another big point through this whole thing is that it's important for us to meet in the physical, to really get a sense of each other and how we can work together and also know each other at a deeper level. But that time in the forest when I was, because the forest is, I mean, it is, it's they're all my friends. All of the little beings that were running around there, they make me so happy. So I had my, it was a little monster hat that had on. And I also get into my deep medicine work in there. And so my native side comes out and I go and I bless all the trees and all the areas. And I remember a moment with you where we both just sat there and we had that really big connection. I was looking at you for a second and I started singing and it just made the entire vortex spin with both of our energies. It was so beautiful.
It really was. But we went into a store at one point because we weren't in the redwoods the whole time. We were driving in the car, we were getting dinner and lunch. And we went into this, it was a Native American Indian, a lot of stuff around, it had flutes. And I just said to you, Z, I said, oh, look, you can play these. And you picked one up and started to play. And I'm like, how did I know that you could play? I just knew. But when you started to play, the whole shop just stopped and everybody was listening, and you brought in this music from your heart, I think, probably, and across all time and space. And it was just incredible to see that. So.
That was beautiful. And you did know.
It
I was like, oh, more of my friends. Yeah, when I pick up the flute, it comes straight from heart. So
Yeah.
beautiful.
So much there to unfold, and so many aspects of all of us that don't come through on the internet, that we get to see as we get to know each other better, which is wonderful. It
Yeah.
really is.
It's a lot of fun. It
Like
is a lot of fun.
honey needs now to buy all the snacks, and she doesn't want to eat them all. She just wants to have them all there in case we need some. So.
I do. I like, and John was like, you have to eat everything.
No,
And of course we didn't.
couldn't bring them with us when we went away. We ended up having to throw some of it out. But
Yeah.
that's it was really about, everything was there to hold us, to serve us, to
Oh,
look
yeah,
after us. And
absolutely. And I was super grateful for John because he really did hold a beautiful masculine that entire time.
yeah, he
All
was
the great
amazing.
dinner for us.
Yeah. I feel like we're appreciating people more and more right now, too. And as we come together in the physical, it's like we get that other layer, but we also get to commune with them, Like the weird little things that we do, we can accept or not accept them, and we know whether we're like part of the same group or not, too. You can kind of see it by the way we interact. How we feel with each other, how we feel like calm and grounded and good, So that was a lot of fun. And it's just fun to be with your soul like group, And I'm realizing now how big they actually are. So they're really big. And to find some of your soul group and hang out with them is just such a like freeing feeling, because most of us have been like the weirdo in our family for a long time,
Definitely.
Yeah.
It's really beautiful to see because we're as beings, we're so multidimensional. And for us to have the ability to get together and just harmonize because we were ourselves, actually, that was really the biggest thing. We were just all ourselves there. And that's what made that really beautiful. We had the space to do that.
Yeah, I think for anybody watching this to know the difference in friendships, between friendships where you're holding back, you're holding your tongue, you can't really express yourself, and friendships where, which is exactly how we hit the ground running, where you can say, I need my space, I need to go off on my own, and you're not taking it personally. I needed to go out for a walk on my own at one point. I think Yuzi, you were up all night one night running around outside. It's like, let people be who they are, whatever that looks like, and meet them where they are. And what I've found recently is, now that I've been doing this more, I just seem to have a lot more tolerance and compassion for everybody, because I'm just looking at them and saying, okay, well, this is where they are, and this is what they need to do. And just because, and I don't even need to say I need them to do something different. I don't do that now. It's like, I don't need them to do anything or to be anything, because I allow myself to be me. And we have to do that more, because then when we fulfill our own needs, no one else is, has to do anything to fulfill those needs for us, which is
Right.
what makes it so freeing in
Absolutely.
relationships.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. It's just a beautiful space of non-judgment and non-attachment. And when we are fully in ourselves, we do come to see each other with such gratitude, love, and respect because we all have ourselves in the space. That's what makes it beautiful. And it also makes it very dynamic. It's a dance, you know? There were a few nights where I was out walking around or going up in the trees because that's what my system wanted to do to move energy and be in the space where it was at. And coming back into the group, it was this beautiful dynamic of dancing and
She froze.
Her energy's frozen. She'll come
The...
back in a minute.
Frozen in the dance.
But that's the
Something
thing,
that
the
was
energy
one of the
hitting off
goals.
each other.
I know.
Are
No, I
you
know.
there, Z? Oh, she's popped
Oh, she
away.
moved.
But it reminded me also of how I told everyone, I mean, you and Z and John, I'm in America. My inner child is going a little bit crazy. She wants to buy all the sweets, all the candy, all the
Right.
things. Here you are.
I might have moved a little bit of energy as soon as I lifted the frequency, it was like drop. I'm like, okay.
That's
Yeah.
okay. That's okay. Yeah,
It is.
it's very much about the energy, but honoring it and naming
Yeah, it's perfect.
it.
It is. Yeah, she froze again.
She's frozen again.
So yesterday I had an experience where we cleared land for people. And it was like this family that's having issues and stuff. And the energy moving, it was like a small group of us that got together. The energy moving changed. They were like, oh, I'm like floating. Like, I don't know what's happening. I feel so weird. And I was like, we moved a lot of energy. So when you're moving a lot of energy and you feel floaty, then, getting grounded is important after you do it, I find. Anyway, oh.
She's gone.
Yeah. So, should we pause for a
Then she's
second? Oh,
back.
there she is. Okay.
Trying to
Right.
ground everything here.
Going with the flow.
Exactly.
Going with the
Yes.
flow. But what's funny is I was coming in from Ireland, and I was going to be in Portland before anyone else. So I just booked a hotel because I knew I'd be tired after such a long flight. And you booked a hotel, honey, too. I didn't realize you were coming in, but you were coming in much later that evening. And this is how the synergy is so incredible. Of all the hotels in all the place, guess which hotel honey booked the same one as me? So
Yeah.
we could meet downstairs for breakfast. It was just so fun to wake up and, oh my gosh, you're in the same hotel. How that works out. So that's the synergy and that's the flow. And I think, Z, what you were saying about how the body is, really doing a lot of processing. It's when the intuition comes from the body and not from the brain.
Right.
You know, as we get clearer in ourselves, that honey will be booking the same hotel as me, or I would just be knowing that that Z can play the flute, or not realizing how, because we're not going into analysis as much. We don't need to analyze so
No.
much.
No,
No,
it
it's
just
going
pops
straight.
in. Yeah, it's just the knowing phase. That is when we've done a work enough self-work that it is dropped fully into the body, and the vessel consciousness, the human consciousness in the vessel, is the one that's completely running the show. And it's like the ego is, you can kind of see it, but it's not running anything.
Exactly.
I think it is.
Yeah, I'm really excited for the expansion of the mind, because I feel like that's the last frontier that we're in right now. Like, the body's upgrading and that's continuing to happen, but the expansion of the mind is going to show us who we are, and just that, like, allowance of peeling away layers that keep you from seeing who you are. I think that's really important right now. That's kind of where we're at right now, to me.
Well, I think if we are the vessel, and I don't just mean our body, but the container for who we are, and the tendency in the past has been to fill that container with worries and patterns and recurring thoughts, and then other thought forms that other people put in there, and distractions, and all of those things. And that's plenty to keep your brain busy. And as we start to take them out, look at them and say, oh, I don't need this one anymore, and not put it back in deliberately, not put so that you empty yourself out, then you do have access to higher levels of consciousness that comes with more information about much more interesting stuff than whether you left the oven on, even though you know you didn't. And you just have to prove to yourself what a fool you are, because people don't need to do that anymore.
Yeah.
It'll give the human race a lot more interesting subject material to talk about, with real relationships and real living, and feeling the magic that we all have access to.
Absolutely.
I think so. Yeah. So we're going to be doing something together that I think is going to be really amazing. It's going to encompass a lot of different things. And we're going to put the link below so that you can go explore it. And we'll probably talk about it again pretty soon. But I feel like the three of us can really contribute a lot to helping people kind of come through this in a beautiful way, so that you can blossom into ascension versus like slam into it. So
Skyrocket to the wall.
I think it's going to be beautiful. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm really, really excited about this, because this is really grounding into our vessels and ourselves and expanding the mind, because the mind really does encompass the entirety of everything. And opening up the gateway to ascension in a way, in a platform that's going to work best for us as individuals and then together as collective. So it's going to be really beautiful.
Yeah.
I'm wondering, Z, can you talk a little bit about differences in perspectives? Because once you and I had that conversation together, everything really cleared for me. And I thought it was wonderful because, the three of us do have different perspectives on things.
Yeah, absolutely. So, perspective is, it's really everything. Everybody has a different perspective point. It can be seen as us three have being different atoms. And when we come together, we co-align, because atoms also too have thoughts. All of those thoughts, they co-align, but they have a different perspective. They have a different sight point. Okay, it's very much so a different observation point. And when we have a different observation point, that allows consciousness to expand and grow, because we analyze at a different perspective. And so it's important to allow everybody to have their own perspective without any judgment, or again, attachment to it. Because honey, if I'm talking to honey right now, she has a very different perspective than I do, but it also co-aligns. And that's how we can expand the most. So it's important to give each other space and room to have different perspectives, because it gives you a full picture. It comes back into self. So it goes out as a picture. I see a perspective point, that's honey right there. And she's going to have a different collective point of view. And then that information is going to come back around to me, and I'm going to have a a broader understanding of who I am and what consciousness is. And that's the next level up in dimension or frequency or higher levels of consciousness.
And I think language plays a big part in that as well, because again, one of the things that we were talking about, and I know Honey and I have talked about this many times, is that we use the same word, but we attribute different meaning to that word. And so to be clear on what perspective point, which is a wonderful way of putting it, that we're putting onto the word so that we can all go, okay, well, you mean this by that word, and I mean this by that word. And I think between the three of us, as we've discovered, we're coming at the three different balance points that people can come in, and it's not like you have to love all of us to do our offering, or that it's just that you feel I'd like to hear three different perspectives around the same topic, and then for you to come up with your own perspective based on actually having these discussions. Because I know that I am totally blessed by being able to have friends like you guys, and when something is like, oh my God, what about this? That we can get on a call really quick and, oh yeah, what about this? And oh my God, and we can work these things out together. But I know not everybody has that. And so to be able to provide a space for that is amazing. And I love the fact that when we've set this up, we're going to have a facility for people to interact with us, ask us questions, and look at things from different perspectives and offer their own perspectives too. So, because we're all navigating through this together.
Yes. This is all together. And you're absolutely right about the words and meanings. The words are very important. They carry a frequency. All of our words do. And your meaning for love is very different from my meaning for love. And those two perspectives really help the collective understand what their own perspective and meaning of love is. And then as a whole, we get to rise up together.
I see these little communities too that are starting because I have a couple of other ones going on. These communities, they're geared towards a certain, like, what do you call it? A goal. But when they interact with each other, when the people begin to interact with each other, it's such a beautiful thing because then they actually get to have somebody to talk to. And they're going to find somebody in that community that they can have like a conversation with that's beautiful. And you get all those perspectives in one soup, but everybody has the same goal. So they're really, they're becoming kind of a collective family doing that. And eventually we'll meet more and more in person. But I feel like this is a great jumping off point for that.
Yes, we're jumping in.
Yeah, jumping
Jumping
in.
into the pot of soup. Thank you
Yes.
guys for being the
Pot of
pot
soup.
of
I
soup.
think
We're
we're a bit more
into
refined
the
than that. We are the crystals in the crystal grid, and we're looking for more people to join us. And I think the fact that the three of us can facilitate very powerful healing makes it a
ocean.
totally different animal altogether. And when we were talking about the kinds of things that we could do, including activations and healings and releasings, and again, meeting the frequency where you are, there could be a month that something is going on and something's very pertinent, and to feel supported by having a connection to community, I think is very valuable. Just to put a background on this, Honey and I last year, or was kind of the most part of this year too, we were doing light worker peer support. And so we set up light worker peer support, which was intended for healers to have somewhere to go to get a support from each other. And it was beautiful and it was lovely, but the way that it was constructed, we didn't feel facilitated as many people as we know that we can facilitate. And I think also the power of three was missing. So we're delighted that Z is here, because that, the balance points are then all held. We've got our own backup, and then we've got backup for everybody. We can hold space for everybody too. And those three points is, it's really exciting. And I don't think we know ourselves how powerful and how amazing it's going to be, because we just get a sense of it in the background there. So
Yeah,
absolutely. It's a knowing. It's also gives it, it really does give it the space for come as you are, because we can, again, we can meet you at that level. And And from that level, you have a greater ability to look further into yourselves and grow from there and have the community to help you in that space. So I'm just really excited to be here. I'm very grateful.
Yeah, I just have to become as you are because that's all I can do. I just go
Exactly. Exactly.
I don't think any of us know how to like fake it anymore. Like if I had to be stuffy and show up in a like at a stuffy dinner somewhere and be a certain kind of way, I don't think I could do it anymore. Like I would just say, no, I'm just not gonna go. So I think that's where we're coming to is if I'm not allowed to be myself, then I'm not interested.
Yeah.
And because yourself is the most beautiful being. That's who you are. So that's what we want to see is you to all be able to be yourselves.
It's the most important thing too. That really is how you ascend, is to truly be yourself. So, and I know that the collective is heading into that point where they have the ability, but it's coming into the space that can hold that as well. And the community where others are doing the same thing. It's huge.
Yeah, and I find as well when, if you're not feeling good and you can turn up somewhere and say, I'm not feeling good, and then get the validation of that, oh, it's not you. There's this energy coming in, and there's this planet is doing this, and this is coming up for a release, and you don't need to go into the mind, and you just, to have that backup and that support. I know it's been invaluable for me over the last while. And I think the squeeze that we're in, it feels like we're being squeezed and running out. That's not going to stop. In fact, my spidey senses say it's going to speed up even more. And I'm not saying it out of fear. I'm just saying it out of a sense of feeling like we've been in training, we've been getting stronger, but what's where we're going next year, because I've looked at the astrology, because I've had to make the diary that I've made. We can't do it on our own as well as we can do it when we're in a group together. And so that's really the biggest offering that we have here is to feel connected.
And it
So
gives you the ideas to move into things that you can do for yourself too. Like you get inspired by other people and you're like, oh, maybe I can do that for myself too. Maybe that's a clue to one of the things that will maybe put me in a further and further elevated state.
absolutely. Or even like a perspective of something you have been working for a period of time, and you come into a group like this, and we all have different perspectives on it, and all of a sudden that's that one thing that you needed to click.
Yeah, that reminds me of when I called a friend and I said, help, help, I need this. And she goes, this is what it is. And I went, no, that is exactly what it isn't. But now I know what it is because I know what it isn't. So that comes into it as well,
Oh yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
Definitely. Definitely.
So it's exciting. It really is. So we're working on putting all the pieces together and we'll have more, I think, over the coming few weeks to add to the gifts that we're offering.
Yes. And just enjoy yourself in the moment, I guess is what I would say. We're doing that and we're really excited to offer this. And we're really happy to see all the growth that's happening, not just in ourselves, but also in everybody else that we're coming in contact with. It's really been a beautiful experience.
Yeah, it really is so massive in the way, because it the cycles per second that we have evolved over the last few months is it's massive. I mean, a lot of people are really stepping into themselves in such a big way, and it just makes me so happy because it has taken humanity quite some time to get on the roll with this. And so for some of us who have had a knowing of this, it's kind of been like, when is this? When is this? When is this? And it was another nice lesson from the universe to be like, well, to get further into yourself, then get further into yourself. So,
Yeah.
but
What
it's
do you
happening.
mean by cycles per second? Can you tell me what that means for you?
Yeah, so I'm talking about energetic revolutionary cycles. Okay, so we all have different cycles that we're running, and that is learning cycles. That is how our energy is vibrating at a particular frequency, whether it's faster or slower. To me, it is a cycles per second, and each human has a different rate, right? And then
Is
the
it like
collective
an
is.
energetic metabolism? Is that what
Yes,
you would?
absolutely. Very good. So we all have separate, and then the collective humanity as a collective has its own revolutionary cycles per second. So it's a dance, and so we're all doing this on our own space, and really in reality, there's only one singularity point, which is us. So it all goes back into us anyways, but it's a beautiful dance, and I would say over the last 4 months, it's definitely increased for everybody, on a massive portion.
Yeah, you
That
can feel
makes
it.
sense to me. Yeah, the cycles per second is your energetic metabolism, and not everyone's gonna have the same, because just like I know based on what the three of us were eating and all the different things, that we don't even have the same physical metabolism, but it would average out. Is that what it is? So that the consciousness as a whole is increasing. And so then maybe you could say these, and I'm going to do quotes, ascension symptoms are the physical body trying to come into balance with the increase in the cycles per second energetic metabolism. And many people feel like they're still catching up with themselves with that. So.
Yes,
And it's
absolutely.
not going to be finished yet, which is what kind of what I was saying, that it's going to get even faster. So would that be right?
That would be absolutely right. And eventually, because right now, humanity, there are aspects of it where they're already going at faster cycles per second, but they're kind of still in the either addiction phase of parts of the ego or whatever else needs to move, when in reality, it's already gone. They're just used to something that has been there for a while, and they're not used to the new aspect. So that brings in something really big of allowing yourself to be worthy of experiencing something new.
Yeah, the willingness to allow change.
That's kind of what I've been doing over the last few years with my people. When I say visualize the archetypal energy of somebody who's well, somebody who has vibrant health, which is not an image that easily comes to mind because society is showing us all the sickness and the illness and the addictions and the patterns and the mental disorders and the neurodivergence, but not really showing us what a well, vibrant, healthy person is. And it is, you're absolutely right. It's like we can be this, but we don't know what it looks like. So it's not the fake it till you make it, because I don't think we can fake anything, like honey, like you were saying, we're not able to fake things, but we have to be able to believe that we can have it, but then we need to create what it is so we can grow into that. And that's like a teething phase. Would you say a teething phase, or like toddlers learning to walk and keep falling down kind of phase?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And the human vessels are restructuring their neural networking patterns. So in this new phase of things, it's like all of those neural networks are expanding and the old ones are dying off. And these new pathways are, it's just very unknown. And we don't have a platform for what it looks like. And so the humans themselves are like, it's walking in the unknown and almost falling off a cliff 24/7 until you realize that that's the best thing ever, because it's the next new step and it's more you, and you can get anything that you want in that phase.
That was like me not wanting to wear half of my wardrobe. So I put it out there in the living room, and my children say, "Oh, can I have this? And it's vintage and it's so great." And I'm like, "Yeah, you take it. It's not going to be me anymore." You know,
Yeah.
we just need to move on. But what we're moving on from might still be of service to other people. So,
Right.
yeah, we're
Yeah.
all in a different phase, and somebody else could make something beautiful out of something that you don't want anymore. It doesn't
Yeah.
mean the same thing to them. They create a whole new meaning for it, you know.
That's true. Like the
Yeah.
sentimental value of all the skirts I used to wear when I was working in the corporate world. And then my daughter comes and cuts one up and resews it together. And I'm like, wow, that's amazing. Or she wore a pair of my jeans one time. And I'm like, I remember being drunk at a party wearing those jeans. jeans. I don't want to wear them, but she doesn't remember that. So it's really interesting.
It is interesting. It really is about what you're holding value in too, because all the things now, they're just things and they're extra energy and they're extra baggage. And do they slow you down or do they keep you uplifted in the highest energy that you could possibly be in? So we'll find value in different things, and really it's just finding value in ourselves and furthering up that process and being able to shed anything that is not of our best, is not of our highest dimensionality that we have, right? So I think the biggest thing too to manifestation right now is really like not being at the vibration that you want to be at to get that thing. It really is, can we let go of the baggage? Can we let go of the attachment of the things that are not working for us anymore, because we're already resonating at that level.
Yeah, it's like a freedom point. When you find the thing that's holding you back and you release it, it's like all of a sudden the things that you've been waiting for start to come in, you know? And it's such a beautiful experience. And usually, you know, it's a layer, there's layers of things, but just releasing that one thing, it's like a cork. Like if you can find that one thing, then it gets easier and easier to peel the layers away and to become more and more yourself. It's just so beautiful.
It
So
is really
that's like
beautiful.
what you said, Z, while we were away as well. Something else you said, which I think was very meaningful, is that we need to give ourselves permission to just feel joy just for the sake of it. Not because, you know, we want to feel joy, so we're convincing ourselves that we're joyful, but we're, you know, or that we're feeling joy because that's the frequency of what we want to manifest now, but just to allow it to come in when it comes in naturally.
Absolutely. Well, and we've had a platform of not joy for such a long time that, again, the newness is, it's a lot for humanity. They're like, I don't even know. I mean, I was out around somebody yesterday who I was in such a joy state, and she had no clue. She was like, are you at some point, like, it was about coming down off of that, or because at some point you're going to come off of that. And I'm like, no, I'm not, because I have permission and I give myself permission to stay at this level and I get to be there. But for her, it's the shift of perspective that, oh, I can actually have this and be consistent with it on a daily basis.
Or else she thinks you're really annoying and is waiting for you to stop because you're annoying her because you're showing her what she doesn't have
Yeah.
or what she's
Too.
not allowing herself to have. So
Right.
it needs to be flipped around. It really does. It's you're the one who's not allowing yourself have that. So
Exactly.
you can get out of your own way and be joyful. So, you know, to remind people of that
That's
is
it.
really
And
important.
I did remind her of that, and she was like, "Oh." Like, you have the same capability as I do, my friend. You know?
Exactly.
That reminds me, actually, when we were in that store with the crystals, I made a bracelet out of two. Do you
Ooh,
remember those
fun.
long lines of beads? So the
Oh,
three
yeah.
of us were in this store and we were looking at all the stuff in the front, and we worked our way back to the back wall where they had all the natural gemstones just hanging there on the wall. And we all started, oh, look at this and look at that. And then there was one moment where it was like all the crystals and the consciousness was like, somebody's admiring us. Oh my God. And then the whole wall lit up, and we're like, whoa, it's just too much energy. It was amazing. But they needed that reminder and we were there. So it's amazing what can happen. You know, the observation, the validation, telling the crystals that they're beautiful and they become beautiful, you know, it's just super. Really, really was amazing.
That was
That
so
was so
fun.
much
Yeah.
fun. I really was. Yeah, and I said it to the woman working there. I said, you must be so lucky working here. And she's like, what? Why? You know, I was like, okay, well, you're not admiring the crystals. You're not getting that joy from being around them. It must be odd because they're just sleeping until someone comes in that knows what they are.
Yeah. Yeah, that was really fun. Because we were touching them, and as we were touching them, we're like, well, this one feels kind of quiet. This one does. Yeah. And then all of a sudden, they're like, duh.
Then
Yeah.
it
That
made
was
it
there
really hard. It's like I have to buy them all now.
again. I was watching you,
Like,
Abby. I was watching you just go, oh my gosh, they're all
oh, yeah, it's like a beckon. It was, you want me to say a bad word? It was like having an electric shower. It was a bath in the most beautiful frequencies. It really was. But the land does that too, when you're looking at the land that way, and can really go, oh, you're looking at me, and it's like it kind of wakes up, and that's where we get the support from.
Yeah.
So it's so
Attention,
good.
it's everything, really, for what we're manifesting. Love
Yeah. Oh,
it.
yeah. Making the
It's one
space for it.
Yes. Yep. All you
Yeah.
have to do is direct thoughts into that, into anything, into one direction point, an observation point, and that shifts the energy right there.
Then
It really
we
does.
together, the three of us, then will be holding space for people who maybe not forget to make time and space for this, but maybe need support to make the time and space for this until it just becomes a natural way of being. Like that woman in the shop, if she knew what she had, she would be just, her energy would be superb, you know? And just by sending those thought forms out into the collective consciousness, it's possible that our interaction with her has made her think about it, and maybe she'll start to try it out for herself. So it's very empowering as well.
It is. And when you're together, you're multiplying the energy. It's not like there's three people together. That means it's three times as, powerful. It's exponential.
Exponential. It's
So,
infinite.
yeah. So that it really is a magic number, three. So I'm excited.
It is.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm excited too.
Yeah. So, well, I feel like we've said all we can say today, and I'm really excited to go through this journey with you two beautiful beings. And
Yay.
it's gonna be great. So, and if you want to join us, I hope that you do, because you're gonna love it. So,
It's going to be beautiful. Yeah.
I think it already is. It
yeah.
is. You're right. A beautiful culmination.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank
Bye.
you so much. Bye.
Bye. Bye.